हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल एट इज़ क्विक लर्निंग। आवर टॉपिक ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन इज सेवन वेज टू टीच क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग इन एलिमेंट्री एजुकेशन। सो दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड ऑफ अटमोस्ट बेनिफिट्स। सो इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ ऑल द एजेस एंड इवन द मेच्योर वंस। सो क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग is very important for the students of all ages, as I mentioned before. So you must see this presentation and understand it for yourself or even for your kids. So defining critical thinking. So critical thinking is the awakening of the intellect to the study of itself. It's like the thing that is already present in your mind. You just has to awaken it. Awaken the intelligent side portion of your brain. So this is a bit more professional and a clear definition. Like, critical thinking goes beyond memorization, encouraging students to connect the dots between concepts, solve problems, think creatively, and apply knowledge in new ways. Despite myths that critical thinking skills are only applicable to subjects like science and maths, the reality is that these skills, which are based on the evaluation and application of knowledge, are not only vital for success in all subject areas but everyday life as well. So this is a very important thing to remember, that many people think that critical thinking is only for science students, but the reality is opposite. You need critical thinking in your daily routine, in your daily life. Even if you have to take a bus or transport from one location to another, you have to be critically intelligent to select which transport suits you the most, which saves your time, money, and which is comfortable for you as well. Then the problem solving loop. So first of all, you have to identify a problem. Obviously, if the problem exists, then you have to start critical thinking. Then you have to explore information and create ideas. Every problem has some information regarding why the problem exists and what thing you want to achieve. Then you have to select the best idea from the list of ideas. Then build and test the idea. And last one is evaluate the results. Is this idea is applicable or not? The idea should be feasible and applicable. So now the critical thinking exercises for elementary education. Now I will tell you some exercises that will increase your critical thinking, and especially this is designed for elementary education. So number one, ask questions. So asking questions, especially open-ended questions, gives elementary school students a chance to apply what they have learned and build on prior knowledge. It also allows them to solve problems and think on their feet and boost self-esteem by providing an opportunity for students to express themselves in front of their peers. So this is the most important point I focus on it, that this is the most important thing, to ask questions. So you should tell your child to ask questions to their teachers, professors, or even to their parents. Then encourage decision making. So since a large part of teaching critical thinking skills revolves around applying knowledge and evaluating solutions, so elementary school teachers should encourage decision making as much as possible. So this enables students to apply what they have learned to different situations, and they should weigh the pros and cons of a variety of solutions, then decide which ideas work best. This will help them in their later life also. They will be confident in making a decision, because decision making is something that involves in your daily routine. Then work in groups. So excellent way for elementary school teachers to encourage critical thinking skills is work in groups. So cooperative learning not only exposes students to the thought processes of their classmates, it expands their thinking and worldview by demonstrating that there's no right way to approach a problem. So working in groups makes you diversify. You deal with different people, different brains, have different ideas, and then you will learn from them and people will learn from you. Then fourth one is, and incorporate different point of view. So some of the very best critical thinking exercises for elementary school students involve exploring a concept from multiple perspectives. So this technique not only establishes that an idea should be assessed from different points of view before an opinion is formed, it gives students a chance to share their own viewpoints while listening to and learning from others. So this is connected to work in groups. Obviously, if you work in groups, you will see the other points of view as well. And then fifth one is connect different ideas. So connecting different ideas is a key to teaching critical thinking. For example, the elementary school teachers can ask students if they know anyone who has to take a bus to work, and if so, why it would be important for that person to also have a train schedule. Questions like these help children consider different situations, delayed buses for example, and potential solutions, taking the train instead, helping them apply prior knowledge to new contexts. This is a very best example given here, very simple and easy to understand. Like if suppose you are taking a bus from your school to home, so should it is important for you to consider the train schedules or not? Obviously it is, because there can be a delay bus, or you want to reach something at more fast than a bus. So this is very good example. Then inspire creativity. So imagination is a key to teaching critical thinking in elementary school. Teachers should seek out new ways for students to use information to create something new. Art projects are an excellent way to do this. Students can also construct inventions, write a story, poem, create a game, sing a song, and obviously sky is the limit. And last one is brainstorm. So brainstorming, a time-honored tradition in elementary school and education, it is an excellent learning tool. It also an excellent exercise, especially when paired with visual elements that bring original thinking and classroom discussions to life. So that's all from our side. Thank you. If you have any question, then feel free to comment us, and kindly like, share and subscribe. This will help us a lot, and kindly tell us which topic do you want to, so that I can make a presentation on it, and what are your suggestions. You are feel free to comment us or message us, and kindly subscribe our channel. Thank you.